Hey, Sashan, what is going on? Thought I'd take a break from working on my book. I watched some, what is it called? Something, something. What is it called? Big Trouble in Little China. I watched the first half hour of it. I'm gonna watch the rest of it today. YouTube surprised me just now with a traveler role play session. Looks interesting. They got some sort of virtual 3D thing going on. This is gonna be crap. This is gonna be like everything wrong with role play is done in this game.
We're live. Oh, we go live. Everyone's like, "I'm stopping the shit talking right now." That's
Oh no, I was needing to make sure the mic was hot so that it would get all of it.
I see.
These are Twitch people. They're Twitch, and for whatever reason, they also stream to YouTube. They don't have any subscribers on YouTube, so it's weird. Maybe they're famous, world famous on Twitch, but I don't know anyone on Twitch that role plays. It's all for jokes, for laughs, for games. It's all, the guys usually hide themselves because they're not good looking, and they don't have cleavage, so. Yeah.
Yeah.
All right. So, welcome to episode 7 of Traveler. Today's episode will be called The Exodus. And we are going to continue our story that we're in like this winding down of this arc, but you guys are totally going to be in control of the paths that are in front of us. But some of that decision making is going to have to be made in situ, because you're going to be thrown into scenarios as we move forward, where I'm just going to say you're in the scenario now. What do you do? And this is going to be one of them. So I'm going to have a rather long monologue here to open up the episode. And if you guys have any questions, feel free to, interject them. But for the most part, let's try to get the opening scene set before we move too much onto what we're doing forward. Everybody cool with that?
Sounds good.
These are D&D players, so you already know it's going to be crap. Just warning you.
All right. I'm going to take that as a yes from everyone. All right. So we left off last time, and you guys had gotten back to the planet, no more than had a meal before. Oh my God, there's another crisis, and you had to go save the spokeswoman, the paladin's wife. From basically from rebels who were, too busy killing other humans to be concerned about the fact that there's giant aliens invading the planet. And you took care of all that. You did a really good job. You brought the person in for interrogation. As after that session was over, you guys came into the into your base of operations, which I guess is the Orkin, and the Prime Paladin had returned and called you guys in for an intelligence summit. During this intelligence summit, there were lots of important leaders giving briefings on all of the super secret things that are going on and gave the party a much wider view of what's going on the war front. And not a lot of this news is actually good news. So the first thing that came to light was there was a deep reconnaissance mission to a neighboring sector that had also been invaded by the Chitin.
Oh, yay.
This reconnaissance mission came
Boring.
back, and the commander of that force reported, he wants to do to defend Zion Tray and the Exodus and all this other stuff. You did
Boring.
get paid every.
When do
Yep,
they start
I'm gonna go
playing?
get it. We'll pick it up.
Okay. Is that the only thing that you're dealing with?
At the moment, I hadn't thought past that, if that's the question.
Yeah, that was kind of.
Don't you hate when people play with their dice during the game? Here we got this asshole's playing with dice on a virtual tabletop game.
That's fine.
Past that thought.
So, let me flip to the map so I can stuff up.
I mean, I might pick up some shotgun ammo, but that's about it.
I'm going to try to get a bunch of camping stuff.
It's a good idea.
These don't do combat.
Oh, you know what? It's probably not designed right. It's probably
I hate when they say they're going to roleplay some traveler and they just do combat. That's not roleplay.
All right, so Mott Durr, you roll in and he's got your hammer. There's a line out his door. It takes like 2 hours to get in there. And when you get in there, his shelves are completely bare. He's got such severe markups. Of course, he's mumbling something to himself.
Hey, where are you guys? Where are the fucking players? Where are they?
Self. And when you roll in, you notice that he's also got boxes stacked behind the counter. That's obviously not weapons, but he's been taking like things in trade in lieu of credits for a lot of his stuff. But you've already paid for yours.
Why are you telling them that stuff? Let them find it out.
So, you have any conversation with him, or you just take your hammer?
What kind of trade stuff you got there?
He's like, well, I figure, food, especially Vargar food, since we're a minority, might be hard.
Vargar? Vargar? Is that what they're called?
Hard to come by, so I picked up a bunch of that, but then, you know, whatever people had that might look like it was valuable, I got a bunch of random stuff in here. I got fuel cells for power armor that I don't even have. I've got a couple of mod kits. Random stuff. If you got something you want to trade for, I've been doing kind of a swap meet thing here. But I'm out of almost all my heavy artillery, grenades, light portable weaponry, you name it. I've sold out.
He needs weapons, so if we had like a stockpile of shit we've been collecting, that would be useful.
I mean, absolutely. What would you want for it?
Don't offer to sell somebody something if you don't know how much it's worth.
I will have to talk to my quartermaster officer about that.
Does he have an advanced base?
Oh.
Like, I want to say something. Oh, I'm not actually the guy who does the selling, though. Oh, you. Why do people do this?
They have an advanced base. That is a thing in the catalog. I don't know if it fits on your ship. Let me check real quick. Probably could get a hold of one.
And if you're going to... If you're going to sell something yourself, you should know what you have for sale. You should know if it's in your inventory or not before you say, oh, let me see if... Ay, ay, ay.
Gravity hammer is awesome.
Buy catalog.
Anyway, so this guy's facilitating a computer. The players are all end users at a computer terminal. Instead of playing like an actual Traveler video game, they're going through this dude who then manually moves crap around on the screen. He's pretending to be a computer.
Bait 56.
Thank you. 6?
Yeah, I'm calling John up. I'm be like, hey, you know that stash of weapons and fuel we picked up?
Sure do.
There's like a fire sale going on right now.
Well, we can make some money then, huh?
I don't know about money, but we could make something.
Okay. Well, I'll get that stuff over there.
That advanced base will fit in your cargo hold. However, if you take that advanced base and you take your tank disassembled into crates, your cargo hold has 1 ton of cargo left. That's it.
You know, let the players figure that stuff out. You know how people will buy a big-ass TV and then they realize their car is too small for the TV? Let that happen.
Hmm.
Also, Mott Dirk.
What is with the zooming in, dude? I don't understand. He's using the app like it's a fidget toy or something.
Or is completely willing to trade you some stuff. Like he'll trade you that advanced base. Like he can get his hands on that.
So the tank is still not fixed yet, right?
Yeah, you guys used the tank in the last episode.
Okay, good. I forgot about that. I thought we had to get it repaired, but I guess we already did.
You already did that.
Skip.
The revolver.
It is shorter range.
Never mind. Just let me keep my hand cannon.
What about
No, the Magrel's longer range.
Is it?
Yeah, the heavy revolver's at 10, the Magrel's at 15.
Who cares? There's other players, but they're not saying.
Oh yeah, word. Yeah, it is. Look at that.
Yeah, the Magrel does have auto 4, so.
Yeah, that means every pull of the trigger, 4 shots.
Yeah.
But it holds 20 rounds versus the revolver 6, so. Yep. You can't turn auto off, it's just always auto?
I think you can turn it.
My god, they're talking about auto fire guns. What's next? Nope, went too far.
Environmental spaces that were designed for other creatures. I'm not telling you how to live your life, but maybe you should refit one of these rooms to maybe being a little bit more elaborate than a bunk that you can have a monitor on.
Why do you keep zooming out, dude?
Yeah, that sounds like a great idea.
This guy's a spaz.
With the tank.
Yeah, the aircraft has a dedicated slot. You do not need anything. Okay, so yeah.
Next.
New book. Holy crap. Why is it not in the new book? Okay.
I don't know where vehicles are, so.
That's problematic. It's in the old book, but not in the new one.
Who cares?
I just.
Grenade, a mind flare.
I just build the dungeons and watch you burn them down. Situation, but the short version is they probably wanted to do things that were illegal and people weren't paying attention to. I know they're not currently in control of the station. There could be anyone out there at this time. It could be pirates, there could be refugees, it could be empty, or there could be Chitin there. Unfortunately, it's outside of...
Let them find out what it could be. Door number one, door number two, door number three. That's all this is so far. What do you do? Which door do you pick?
To working with you, I've heard amazing things about you.
Oh, really?
I hope you live up to the hype. I'll see you in orbit. She gives you a quick little salute and heads out.
Notice that NPCs always seem to know the characters. Remember in Half-Life? In Half-Life, you're walking around as that Freeman guy, and everyone knows who you are. Anyway, in Traveler, chances are no one knows who you are. No one. They don't give a rat's ass about you. You have to prove yourself.
I look at Zach.
Because you're traveling, right? You're traveling from planet to planet. The news is behind you. It news hasn't caught up with where you're going.
And you're the hacker, right?
Really? Episode 7? You don't know who the hacker is?
Not necessarily. I think I might be the best of us here at computers, but...
Can you, like, at least talk in character when you roleplay? Are you even roleplaying? It's like we're solving puzzles and we're asking questions. It's a quiz game that we're playing here with the referee. Ay, ay, ay.
Is this like the last campaign where Kizik has all the fancy gear and you have the skill points?
Don't you hate it? I hate it when players talk about previous game sessions. Why?
I have no idea.
Yeah. No, I'm not. I have A rank in electronics.
All right, well, I'm going to look at...
The players can't seem to remember what they even did in the last episode, because they probably did nothing except ask a lot of questions.
My two, my side guy and my hacker, and I'm going to tell them to find me everything on InGen.
Hey, God.
I want my characters to just buy all the things. Just automatically buy all the things.
I don't know if that's a reasonable request, but...
Okay, so the guy should sell you all the things and then be done with it. What are you doing here still?
I've been making unreasonable requests for so long. Who cares?
I mean, shady corporations often deal with the criminal underground, and you also have a member of your crew who knows lots about the criminal underground.
Oh, good point.
Oh, that's right. Thanks for reminding me. Oh, yeah. Why doesn't the referee just play this solo with himself, not have the players slow down his game?
Find out any of their... I look at... God, I cannot remember any names.
You suck. Okay, what's next?
You've been given the coordinates of this station. Your first mission is to jump ahead of this fleet and land on this station.
So this Exodus was a game from Mongoose Publishing for Traveler. I have no idea if it was any good. I'm guessing it wasn't.
And secure these supplies. You're given a basic layout of the station. The station has three levels. The bottom level only has cargo airlocks. The mid-level has a docking port, and the top level has a docking port. They're divided out into engineering and research spaces, which is the middle level, and living spaces, which is the top level. The bottom level is obviously only cargo. That's relatively decent schematics of the place. With that said, you have no idea how the ship place has been modified. You also have a full threat briefing from the Paladin.
Just tell them everything.
...listed as being unsuccessful, but there is a ton of genetic data for three distinct species. One is amphibian, one is reptilian, and one is mammalian. None of you are doctors that know biology, right?
Dun dun dun!
Not me.
Point medic.
Point medic isn't quite gonna cut it.
You knew that A stands for something.
Next.
Three of them, ironically. I'm sure everyone is completely shocked by that.
Yep.
Super shocked. The ship is painted up with all sorts of graffiti, including one you recognize as a known pirate band.
Oh no, it looks like combat. How long does this go on
Probably.
For?
Probably. It could...
Hey, they're in a ship now.
I think Mr. Ghost wanted to do something with the other guy.
Yeah, I know he did.
Let me see how I roll. If I roll terribly...
Ghost could always help clean up the mess.
Why do you keep fussing with your...
I got an 11.
Okay.
Have you seen that commercial where they turn Iron Man into a soda can?
So, what were you trying to do, Ghost?
What do you do?
So, I want to grab this guy, basically, and put him into a full Nelson, so that I've got him subdued, and unfortunately, his head is pointed right towards his buddy, as his buddy's head goes in through his chest. That's what I think is happening here.
Okay, do you want that to render him unconscious or kill him?
Door number one or door number two?
I'm trying to just restrain him.
He's introducing a...
Like they can barely say what their character's doing. Just barely.
Persuasion,
I got you. So he just vomits as his friends, you know, impales his diaphragm.
Yes.
Okay. So he retches. He's stuck in your headlock. This is your story to tell. How does this go down?
I whisper or growl into his ear. I say, how many more of you are on this ship?
There's the captain and like he's got like four more up on the bridge and
these floating hands are so annoying.
And there's a couple of slaves in the quarters and that's it.
And how many shuttles do you have out right now?
We got three.
And how are they staffed?
Everybody.
What kind of questions are you? And where's your HR department?
He's on the shuttles. That's where all the boys are.
Numbers, man. Give me a count.
And where's your little boy's room?
I can't count that high, man. It's a couple dozen, man.
All right, kid. What's your name?
Dan.
Dan?
Yeah, can you let me go? It really hurts.
I loosen my grip just a little bit, and I say, Dan, do you want to live through this?
Oh, yeah, yes, I'd really like to live. What the hell are you guys?
Like your buddy right here, okay? Dan, I'm going to give you an option. You can stop hanging out with these guys, because have you ever heard of Zion Trey?
Out there, because when that thing cracks, it's going to... gonna suck you all out. Come on, quick.
So they shuffle up to the broken door. Okay. They hastily drop some of the crappiest guns you've ever seen before in your life.
Yep.
You gonna let them out?
Yeah, I let them by. Okay. I'm attempting to maintain a space between them and the crack because at some point that's gonna break and suck all them out.
Yeah. Well, the other thing is you just broke the airtight door. So.
Yes, I know.
So, it doesn't immediately completely crack, but it is going to.
Is that the only air?
Why don't you just tell them how the fucking quest ends?
Airtight door
can do on that?
Sort of just unchain them and make sure that they are treated like normal people again.
What are you guys doing?
They can...
It's a hallway,
yes,
right?
I can take you to the captain's quarters.
This is just a hallway here. What are you guys doing? You guys gonna stand in this hallway for an hour? What are you doing?
Orders.
You should do that, Pete.
Okay.
When did I ever see a space movie where they stood in the same hallway for an hour? I don't understand.
Who's the fourth in command?
It's a single stateroom, standard terminal, latrine. It's not very fancy. It's a subsidized merchant.
Yeah, I'm just looking for a computer.
Latrine? This guy doesn't even know what to call stuff in the game. Finally, looks like they leave to do something.
These guys don't get collected.
Oh no, they're still
these guys. These guys didn't make it.
John, I don't really think there's any danger that they blow the station up.
I'm actually
worried about something different.
Here's my issue: if Ingen wants it blown up, I don't want it blown up.
We probably should have kept Dan so that we
What
could,
other non-roleplay have they been doing? This is what? This is
a red shirt?
Goddamn, 2 hours.
We should have kept Dan as a red shirt.
You still got
2 hours in. They haven't really done squat, have they? That's a movie right there. 2 hours is a movie. What did they do?
Still got the yokels. You got Jimmy Bob and Bill Bob.
That's fair. It would have been great to find out that Dan was actually a Billy Bob.
What is with the zooming in and out?
As long as he's out of Kevin.
You wanted to go to the top floor?
Yeah.
I thought we went mids.
Ooh. I thought we said the top one.
Okay.
You can change your mind at this point, but once you're bored...
Well, I feel like the research place is not the place you want to start.
Yeah, okay, so top floor is residence, right?
Yes. I would also say, however, that if the residence became corrupted with whatever they had, then it's just as bad. But just as bad is not the same. I mean, not knowing means the residence would be the better choice.
Well, while you guys debate that, I'm going to take a bio break.
Bio break?
Okay.
These guys are gay.
And instead of dirt, it's shards of metal. It looks like something punched through with a steel punch and then like shredded bits and pieces of it.
So okay. No acid.
Is it a tunnel?
Okay, Deacon.
Yeah.
You think you can just walk up there?
Can just poke it with a stick.
You know what makes it a flak suit? Are the metal armor plates in it?
I thought they were ceramics.
Yeah, ceramics.
10.
Oh, it's melee. I've got 9.
Okay. So, Sterling stabs it in the eye with the stealth dagger. Maul wrenches it. Secondary sensory thing. Like, it's probably nearly blind now that you're.
What are they trying to do anyway?
I don't know. Left. Somebody left.
Rats? There's rats now? What is this?
Raccoon.
Oh.
How long have they been standing in hallways?
I wonder if he knows he left.
They've been standing in hallways.
He just fell asleep like an hour ago, so.
For an hour. For an hour. They've been dealing with the same
so a flame rifle, shotgun, what are we doing?
I got a 10 on the flame rifle.
That was very ready. Okay, go ahead and add your effect to your damage.
Any day now.
Guess who's back?
Back again.
Hero.
Yeah, I've been really quiet.
We're
looking at a 14.
Okay. That's a shit ton of damage. That's enough to do this one and this one and this one and this one are now flaming jets, and these two scurry into this hole.
Can I shoot them with the shotgun as they scurry away?
Sure, go ahead and give it a shot.
Mother, may I?
Oh, I got a 7.
Now they scurry into the hole. Yeah. There's burning rats. They smell pretty bad.
Mm-hmm.
I start turning on the vac suit filter.
Yeah, we probably should keep that on.
I mean, yours can be on, but those with compromised suits are going to get little whiffs.
Can I?
Another mother may I question? What have I said before? The referees, the GMs, the dungeon masters, 99% of the time they're going to say yes. So why the fuck are you asking questions?
Patch my suit with the bulkhead things?
Not without a mechanics check.
Okay. We have a mechanic, right?
Sure do. That's what Deacon...
This GM is weird. He's like, you can't, but someone else can. And then the players like scratching their head. Who else in the game can do what I need done for me? These are like D&D players. They're the worst.
Deacon does.
All right.
You guys slip the green key card in this thing?
Yeah.
I'm very proud of this thing. Oh no, it broke. I'm not proud of it anymore. It's fucking busted.
So he wanted to do something, and the guy says, well, someone else can, but. It's like, is that even something you can do in a hallway when you're fighting things? Or is that stuff you do when you're, like, not in combat?
Jinxed it.
Tabletop Simulator betrayed me. That was a joint on a hinge that, like, the bridge floated down into position, like, super perfectly. Sad. All right, there's a maintenance bot in here. There's a mainframe.
Stop waving around.
Let's set the. you guys hear that?
Cackling? That's me.
Oh, I thought you were. The dog is growling at the cat. Anyway, let's set the droids to not attack our new friend.
The droids don't attack. They're too dumb for that.
No, the droids were.
Oh, fixed. The gun droids. Okay. Yeah, you can do that. You have parameters for it. So you need a medical check. Just basic pass, that's a 6. And to do a scan of it. And then you need computer's check of 8 to go ahead and program it. Your key card that you got, the data wafer the Deacon got, allows access without any further checks. Like, you don't have to hack into this thing. You slide it in and it lets you have control.
All right, so can we transfer the data file to our ship?
Absolutely. What do you want, the whole thing?
Yeah, everything incriminating.
So everything incriminating isn't everything. The reason I ask is because there's a ton of data on here. There's more data than your ship computer could ever take. Alternately,
I can't take it no more. I got this far, though.
Two of these racks are storage racks, and you could take the drives physically with you.
Oh, that's a good idea.
Just tell them what to do.
All right, that makes more sense, assuming we make it that far, yeah.
All right, tell the robot to start doing that.
Now, the robot does tell you, well, sorry, the central computer does tell you. Oh, I forgot to do the login accepted thing, because, you know, you brought the right thing. Login accepted. Look, I spent a long time doing that. It does tell you as soon as you start taking the data drives out, the station's going to start shutting down. So, like, the station needs the drives to operate.
Why would you tell them that? You know, in the old days, the GM would say, "Are you sure you want to do that?" And that's it. That's all they would say. Now it's like, "Well, if you do that, then this is going to happen, blah, blah, blah." It's like, stop messing with the camera. Leave it somewhere. Okay.
Alternatively, couldn't we just send the transmission, or it won't go far enough?
It'll get there eventually, but it doesn't travel faster than light. So, like, transmissions need to be carried via ship to another area, and your ship doesn't have the storage capacity to carry all the data.
Dun, dun, dun!
All right, that's one thing down. We'll deal with that on the way out.
You just told the players kind of a big deal about Traveler. Radio signals don't go faster than light. And they're like, oh, okay. Not like they're going to use radio signals anyway. They just sit around and wait to be told what to do next by the guy running the game.
Because I don't think we're ready for this to be shut down yet.
Yeah, I don't know.
Can we tell I don't the know. Droids Did you? To start loading the... crates of food into our ship?
I don't know. Can you?
You're going to have to manually go down to the cargo level to do that, but you can do that from there. What you can do is unlock the cargo doors from here.
All right. So we do that.
Did anyone even touch the computer yet in the computer room? They're just kind of like standing there. I'm near a computer. Okay. That's the extent of my role play for now.
Sheer, are you actually standing all the way in the back? Is this a relative formation to where you guys are at? Can you give me another agility check?
Oh no!
Right. Oh sure.
Sorry to pick on you, but you're just in the wrong spot.
Oh no!
Am I?
He's been standing in the hallway all this time. Whatever for?
Agility.
There's no agility. Well, I guess if it's a skill, I suppose there's an agility.
So one of the rats has like snuck up on you, and you just see it at the last minute, and it tries to run up and bite you, and you just kick it, and it falls into the pit.
Fucking frat.
Let the player narrate what they're doing.
Pilot those at the main targets for the drones.
Okay. Go ahead and activate the drones. The drones start sweeping through the facility. There is the occasional blast of energy weapon fire.
How many more of those dog things do you think there are?
Who cares?
Ask the same.
That's like asking, I wonder if there's any slave girls on this planet and how many there are. I mean, who cares?
Can you ask the ask Mahler?
You're in a computer room. Ask the computer these things.
Reach out. I'm going to ask enemies how many.
What? It's going to like show you.
Is the guy even awake? Did someone just wake up during the game?
You memories kind of deal. Like it's learning to link to you in a more profound way. It doesn't know an exact number, but it's seen at least three of them at a time. So it knows there's at least three.
You guys suck.
I don't want to go in there.
So there's a purple light in the hallway. There's a skeleton. And then there's a console that says bio. Well, you can read it.
Decontamination controls.
Oh, no. Another room. Completed. Another room for everyone to stand in.
Exactly.
Okay. So you start the plasma jet up and start trying to torch these containers. The containers instantly shatter because the boiling water is expanding inside the containers, which in turn sprays its contents everywhere, including at you. You are able to hold the plasma jet in front of you and create kind of like shield of burning plasma at the very last second. And you eventually are able to get all the containers to the point where you're relatively certain all the tadpoles died. With that said...
Another 10 minutes.
Say cook at 1400 for another 10.
They're rolling dice way too much. Way too much.
10 minutes.
I like my steaks well.
Well.
Yeah, that seems wet, like from not PFC. A good idea.
That would work though.
I've already kind of like compromised the space station with the Gauss rifle.
Do we have anything in our survival kits that would...
You don't know what you have in your survival kit?
Do anything to help that?
I don't know. Do you? Do you even have it with you? Did you look inside of it?
The problem is we'd have to open the door. You know what?
For the sake of speeding things up, I will say that it's embedded itself in the glass of his helmet, so there are a couple of options. Either you could somehow remove it.
Just tell them how to do everything. Tell them how to solve all the problems.
From the glass, which would require a rather delicate...
Notice how when he's talking, the players are deathly quiet. They're all listening. Because he's telling them how to get through the game. Here's what you got to do.
Procedure. Or he can leave the helmet behind. If he leaves a helmet behind, he's going to have to make another check to make sure he doesn't touch or inhale anything on his way out.
Oh, no. Tell them about future die rolls they may have to make.
Would compromise him as a person.
Can we, is there any way that,
Yeah, I'm going to try to clean it first.
You also can go back in, and then we can come in and try to help.
That is true. Look, if he goes in, then the could turn purple again, and then we can fix it.
Yeah, that's true.
Yep.
I'm going to go in here anyway to try to find a cleaner.
Maybe use the flamethrower.
I like their narration. I'm going to go in here, and then bloop, just walks through the door. The door's not even open. They just walk through a closed door into another area. I'm going to go in here, and, okay, that's your turn, asshole. Let someone else do something.
They were on the ground a little more.
Like, why are these people still standing out here for, like, an hour? What is that about?
Or just to be sure.
Is it this guy's time to shine in the sunlight? Is that how they say, his chance in the spotlight?
Or we can ask Mahler if the place is clean now.
What's with all the hands moving around? Derp, 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 derp. All that time wasted moving the hands around, they could have been role-playing.
All right, we go in.
do an infrared check or something like that. Maybe we'll be able to see something with the little tadpoles or something. I don't know.
I mean, Maul, when you guys go in, the first thing he did a number on this place. This place, like the whole side of the lab is just baked. Molten, like it's molten metal. Like that's
so IR not going to help much.
Yeah.
Everything is red.
Yeah.
Bright red. All right.
It's also worth noting that the Halon suppression system is kicked on, but you're all wearing vac suits, so.
Good thing you say these things, otherwise the players might forget what they're wearing.
All right, I'm going to ask the robot if there's any disinfectant, because he's cleaning the floor, he would know.
I'm guessing the players are waving around, clicking on everything. You know, clicking on all the shiny stuff in the game. See what it does.
It's not going to say anything, but it does have a bottle of, like, floor cleaner on it. Also, there's a bunch of surgical tools here, so there's plenty of stuff available for you to grab.
Yeah. Let them find that out. You know, go up to the table here. Look at stuff. It'd be nice if there were walls to this place. There's probably lockers and crap on the walls.
Is there like a mini torch?
$1 million in gold bars here?
There is a laser scalpel on each of these benches.
Alright,
I'm gonna do the thing that will get me the most, what are you guys doing exactly? Going in and out, in and out, in and out. You go into a room, you do the thing, you leave. What is there left to do?
Have Sammy or Deacon attempt to destroy the thing embedded in his helmet.
Okay, who wants to do it?
The scalpel shouldn't cut through the helmet, but it should destroy the thing, right?
I mean, it would eventually cut through the helmet.
Like, I'm a player in the game, and I haven't really got to do anything, so, and I've been wanting to get this thing out of my helmet, and maybe now's my chance to do it. So, screw you guys, I'm going to do what I've been wanting to do the whole game.
But I'm assuming you're just going to try and take, like, the top couple millimeters off.
Yeah.
Delicate face surgery, I'm on it.
It's
a mechanics check.
I feel like it's a medical check, and it should probably be the doctor, but that's just...
We'll have the doctor do it. We'll put John on the bench here.
I can do the medical stuff. do we want to do a roll a check, or do we want to... sorry, not check, but any assisting?
Can you role play at least? So it sounds like you guys know what you're doing, and then a role play, a role can be made. Half the time, rolls don't even need to be made. Like, what do we have to do for that? What kind of roll do we need to do to get that, to make that happen?
Yeah, so you're going to definitely want to be assisted. Also, John, you're probably pretty uncomfortable because when you lay down in this bed, it's blatantly meant to surgically modify animals with robotic arms.
This is some weird shit, man.
Okay, I'm done.